What's up, guys? There is not so much to tell about the price of Bitcoin, what is happening, but still I would like to make a short update. And generally what is happening is that we are forming another channel, sideways channel, the similar one which we had here. Instead of making a significantly lower low or maybe a higher high, we are actually consolidating in the area between 9,900 and something like $10,650. I don't think that it will last too long, but apparently, first of all, it wasn't the squeeze as we might expect, because this drop might return back to the area above $11,000. It didn't happen, and we are just forming this consolidation channel instead of growing. And at the same time, if that was a major correction, it would be much faster drop, I think, because usually the inertia is strong, is huge, and we are continuing to falling lower and lower and lower. Instead of that, we are consolidating here. So it is kind of a 50-50 situation right now. We are seeing higher lows, higher highs recently. So there's a little hope that we actually will break the level of $10,600 and maybe have some price action above it. But at the same time, it might be just a false breakout as we had here. So moreover, we have this CME gap above 10,425, and we didn't feel it yet completely, so it would be reasonable if we will actually feel it to 200% and maybe even go a little higher than that. And also there is another gap below it, so both of those gaps are positioned like above one of those gaps is positioned above this channel, and another one is below the channel. So it means that those false breakouts like they were here are very reasonable to happen and expected to happen before the true significant move of the price. And moreover, you see we kind of having the ascending wedge here, which is currently a bearish formation, because again the ascending wedges are bearish in general, but also we had this downtrend move preceding this wedge, and we have this also the volume decreasing. So I don't think that it will last too long before some move to the upside or to the downside. And generally I think like locally maybe first move will be to the upside, I believe. That I don't know, I wouldn't say that there is any significant signs to that, but still just my personal expectation, I think that we will go higher at least locally. But the thing which is kind of bothers me is that Bitcoin used to go together with the traditional markets, and we see that stocks are printing lower lows, and it doesn't look optimistic at all at the moment. So it's actually worse than this one and worse than this one. So I'd say that we have a very fair chance to go even lower. Moreover, another one asset which is kind of a leading for Bitcoin is gold. And although you can see here is a kind of a triangle, right? And moreover, you can think that this is a bullish pennant here, or bull flag, or more a pennant, that it's supposed to be broken to the upside. However, if you look at the let's say a weekly time frame, then you'll see that this is actually quite crazy rise here. So after the consolidation period, gold start to rise, and you see that this slope is like making it faster and faster. And usually the like local high happens at the point of the maximum acceleration. Of course, we may make another leg to the upside with even more like vertical, almost vertical price action. But the thing which I'm looking at now is that currently price actually broke this trend line, which is not so great. Of course, it did happen here as well, so we might return here, but still a little bit alarming considering especially the speed of the growth was here. And if gold continues going lower, then Bitcoin will probably go lower as well. We should be patient and wait for the breakout pretty much the same way as we did here, or as we did here. So until then, it's hard to predict in which direction breakout will occur, so the stop orders are really, really important. Okay guys, another thing which I was going to point out today, that we are heading to the new championship on SnapX with a huge pool of price, and I'm going to make a new team for for this championship, and you can also participate. In order to do that, you'd need to go to this link, which I leave in the description, and then log into your account. It should be verified. I'll probably make a more detailed video about that, how to do that. But in general, you need to click this join a team and then enter crypto hamster here in the field of the name of the team or the team's leaders, and you will see our team. You can click here and join this team. So currently is the early bird registration. You will get $10 each for first 10 participants if we'll do it fast. So go ahead and join if you want, but again, you'd have to trade real money if you want to get price, so keep that in mind. In any way, I would try to maybe make some signals on our Telegram account to make some profitable trades, and if we'll be among the best traders, then we are having a chance to get some additional cash, so it's not that bad. Until then, I will keep you updated on the price of Bitcoin and what is happening, so stay tuned, and thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope to see you in the next video. Safe trading. Goodbye.